Greetings all, it's the Devious Monkey here. Okay, it is, and what day is it? Thursday. It's the day after I got my second Moderna shot for COVID. So I took the day off because I read a lot of shit about people saying they had a horrible time after getting the second shot. The first shot I had, you know, I mean, I always have a headache anyways, but it was a lot worse, especially after I went to sleep the day that I got the shot. That has been a repeat of this time. This time I went to sleep. I felt great last night. I didn't have any problems. Then I went to sleep and I ended up, you know, my usual waking up every now and then. And I could feel that headache again. That's different from the normal headache. And when you have that kind of shit as much as I do, you get to know the difference between like normal crap and this isn't the same. Something's up. So I did have that headache and wow, did my freaking shoulder get painful. Painful to the point that I couldn't even sleep on that side. Like I'd start to roll over and it would wake me up and I'm like, ah, holy shit. You know, like, ooh, okay, that's really tender. I can only sleep or sit or whatever. I can only be in one position for so long before my spine's like, eh-eh. So I was on my back for quite a lot of the night and Spiny wasn't having it. In typical dumb monkey fashion, I forced my shoulder to deal with the fact that I was laying on it. So I laid on it until eventually the hurt, I either got used to it or just stopped hurting like it did when I first rolled over onto it. And that's kind of how my night went. Now, I checked my sleep app and I was actually pretty shocked that I didn't have a crappier night's sleep. It actually wasn't too bad. The usual, I didn't get enough of it, and I really didn't get down in the deep, and I had a couple of big spikes of waking up, probably when I rolled over onto my shoulder. But all in all, not too bad. Now, today, I decided, since I'm not working, difficult as it is for me, I am not going to be running all over the place. You know, like, this would be a perfect day for me to go on a hike in the state park, like a 5 to 8 mile hike. But I'm not going to do that, because that would be dumb monkey-ish. I got up and I made a liquid breakfast. I make like this protein type shake, green based, blah, blah, blah. And I potted a cup of coffee. Now, I don't know if it's because of this shot or because I used different ingredients in the drink, but the coffee tasted like shit. And So I dumped it and I'm on my way to Three Ships now to get us coffee. And I'll go take our coffee at the library. And that's kind of all I plan on doing today. I have gotten work calls and work emails. Yeah, I know, I looked. I can't help it. And I will call the person back that called me because he's cool, he deserves a call back. But otherwise, I'm not doing any work today. I'm not doing any crazy walking around, you know, photo shooty filming shit. It is, again, a gorgeous day, so I think I might perhaps eventually go back to the boardwalk and just sit outside and observe life. The world's my oyster. In this respect, I'm just going to chill. I don't feel bad. I definitely don't, you know, I don't have a migraine. I don't have nausea. I'm not dizzy. I just kind of feel, you know, not optimal. We'll leave it at that. So I'll just have a nice, easy day. But for now, I need some caffeine. So let's go get some Bean. I walked in, I got my wife her drink. And it was very loud and I couldn't hear what the girl was saying. I just asked for something with a shit ton of caffeine in it. She said something I couldn't hear and I said, I'll just try it. I got some kind of a milkshake, which apparently has a lot of caffeine in it. So it's very twasty. It's so twasty. It's also pretty sweet, a little bit sweeter than I like stuff, but what the hell. I'll get a sugar high and a caffeine high to combat my Moderna blues. All right, it's time for me to crank Joy Division. We'll be back. All right, coffee's been delivered. Trying to make sure that my body has all the energy it needs to heal and deal with this vaccine, which means not overloading it with a bunch of gunk, which is always good to do every once in a while anyway. So today's pretty much gonna be a liquid kind of a day. Not to mention, it's incredibly warm out and I'm headed to the boardwalk now. I brought Doink along. I think we're gonna do a little photo shoot. I'm just gonna chill. I can already see that it's breezy here, which means it's gonna be really breezy down at the boardwalk. I am just going to sit there and just be and enjoy the day. I still keep looking at emails because I mean I have my phone out and all that kind of stuff, and annoying as ever, but I'm not doing any work today. I refuse. I have a day off. I never take days off. So as I continue to watch other creators and I see people that do these amazing videos, granted, they aren't posting every day. Their videos aren't vlogs. Mine are. That's the biggest reason why I don't really get crazy with production value and putting in all kinds of special effects and all kinds of weird shit. It's a daily vlog. You know, I've never claimed to be a cinematic masterpiece channel or anything. And now that my passion for straight photography has been rekindled, I mean, that's kind of what this is all about. I have always enjoyed photography a lot. It's always been at the heart of anything that I endeavor to do creatively. I did take the last year to force myself into the video side of it because I kept shooting hundreds and hundreds of hours of video and then never editing it and posting it, which was stupid. Now, I mean, it doesn't take much to shoot a video and post it every day. Sometimes it's a little bit more labor intensive depending on what I'm shooting and how much I have to cut out and all that kind of crap. But otherwise, this is a daily vlog. This is a daily vlog of my day, of how I go through my day, you know, and a lot of that has to do with my creative endeavors. As you can see though, since I got the a7R IV and the Sigma lenses and the flash and, you know, all the little things that are associated with it, I haven't been buying anything. You note that I haven't been talking about, oh, I had to go get a package and pick stuff up. Yes, I got the Mobilo card and the accessories for that just because I wanted to, you know, have something like I showed in yesterday's video where somebody comes up to me and approaches me and I can give them my information right away. That's a drop in the bucket compared to how much crap I usually used to buy. I'm not buying stuff now because I literally have everything that I want. Now I just need to keep creating. And instead of me taking video cameras out and going everywhere and shooting video, that's just sort of the tool now that I use to document the photography, because the photography is where it's at for me. And that's kind of how I am going to be going forward. It's why I don't feel like I need to go out and buy a Sony FX9 or a RED camera or anything like that, but I don't need it. I don't need to do that. I could get rid of both A6600s and the ZV-1, you know, and go buy an FX3 or an A7S III. But I don't really need to do that because, again, now that the Insta360 firmware update fixed all the shit that I was complaining about, and I realized that I was a dumbass and stopped doing the things that I was doing wrong, that's all I need to film a daily vlog. Yes, it's nice in the studio that I have my Cinerig set up and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, I can always take that out and do a little bit more cinematic videos, whatever that means to you. But for the most part, that's not what I'm about. That's not what I'm doing. At one time, and this was several years ago when I first started doing this, yeah, I was all about the filmmaking and all that kind of stuff. That was after, you know, I was deep into my photography though, and I was still doing that. Now, after all this time, all this gear, all the stuff that I've been doing, I know for a fact that deep in my heart, photography is my passion. And I enjoy it, and I enjoy the gear that I have to help me do that. And I have, I won't say rekindled, my passion for going out in nature, because I did that all the time. Like I said, I used to do walkabouts all the time, and I kind of consider those walkabouts, going out and doing street photography, the same thing as birding. I'm just catching a different animal. But that being said, I have clearly taken to birding and I have really been enjoying that. Now that I have that a7R IV, the Sigma 100 to 400, the gimbal head for my tripod, the gimbal head properly set up for my a7R IV and Sigma 100 to 400, I plan on doing a lot more birding or just nature type things in general now that it's nice out. That's pretty much the way it goes. That's where I'm going with this. Now, do I need to show you that every day? Do I need to go out and take pictures of the same birds every day and show you that? Probably not. I mean, it's gonna get boring. You're not gonna wanna see it. What I am trying to do though is just perfect, or not even perfect, but just get better at what I'm doing. That's what this is all about. This is forward and up. Me finding what I want to do, first of all, and then after I find it, find the best gear possible that I can afford that allows me to do that. And then once I get the gear, start doing it and getting better at it and enjoying it more. And I hit that spot. I've got all the gear that I need that I like for now, and I have enjoyed going out and doing all this stuff. And now every time I go out, I find one more thing that maybe I shouldn't be doing, and finding something that is a better way of doing it, and it just makes me enjoy it that much more. So that's it. That's what this channel is going to be going towards on this journey, moving along with me in my photography and just getting better and better at it, and hopefully trying new things. Those new things are old things, of course, because I need to get back to the human beings. I have had a couple people reach out to me, but timing just hasn't worked out right. Now that the day job has changed and I got to get back on the road here, probably in the middle of May after my vaccination has fully kicked in and everything, then I'll start traveling to new places and taking pictures of new things. And I'll be bringing you along with me. You're more than welcome to come and enjoy what I'm enjoying, or you can find somebody else. That's the beauty of the internet. It's the beauty of YouTube. There's no shortage of creators out there that are doing something that you want to know, that you want to see, that you enjoy watching. So I encourage you to break out of your small little niche of what you're watching and look at some other stuff, because I don't just watch photographers or videographers. You know, there's other people out there doing really cool shit that actually helps me with my videos and my photography, and that's what it's all about. All right, off my soapbox. That's it. I'm gonna go down here. I'm gonna enjoy the rest of my day off as best I can, feeling all weird and shit. Thanks for joining me as always. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.